Hi, my name is Ken Chan. I'm an applications engineer with the High Speed Products Group. This presentation is the transmit signal chain implementation for wideband and high frequency signal generation. The hardware for this active amplifier interface for high speed DACs is implemented as the TSW3080AWG. The agenda for today will cover an overall system view of the arbitrary waveform generator and its functional blocks. We will then discuss the different arbitrary waveform generator amplifier paths, which include a wideband signal path, a high dynamic range path, and a differential wideband signal path. Finally, we will explore the design methodology for each of the paths. The typical arbitrary waveform generator consists of input controls for the user to change and adjust the desired output signal. There are processors to generate the desired digital pattern and the analog output path, which includes the DAC to synthesize the signal and amplifiers to provide the DC coupled drive circuits. This presentation is going to focus on the different options for the analog outputs depending on the needs of the system. The TSW3080 arbitrary waveform generator includes the various blocks as mentioned in the previous slide. The DAC38J84 performs the conversion from digital patterns to analog voltages. The THS3217, THS3091, and LMH5401 provide the driver functionality to drive 50 ohm loads with larger voltage swings. The LMK04828 provides the clocks required by the DAC and the digital pattern generator. The digital baseband processor function is performed by the PC and FPGA on the TSW14J56 evaluation platform. This block diagram shows the function of the various blocks in the TSW3080 arbitrary waveform generator demo. The PC and HSDC Pro provide the user interface to control the pattern that will be generated as well as control the configuration of the DAC. The FPGA on the TSW14J56 will serve as the baseband processor and playback of the pattern stored on the DDR3 memory on the TSW14J56. The digital patterns are then sent to the DAC, which will replicate the analog voltages described by the digital pattern. These analog signals are then filtered to remove any images to smooth out the analog signal. One of the four DAC outputs is routed to a THS3217 and THS3091 path to provide a high swing output capable of driving 26 volts peak-to-peak into 50 ohms. Another DAC output is used along with the THS3217 to provide a 5 volt peak-to-peak path driving a 50 ohm load. The third path is used along with the LMH5401 to provide a wideband differential output. The final fourth path is used through a wideband transformer to provide a reference signal to compare to the other three paths. Some details of each of these blocks will be provided in the next several slides. The DAC38J84 is a 4-channel 16-bit 2.5 gigasample per second DAC. It is capable of taking in a signal with 1 gigasample per second of complex bandwidth per IQ pair, with a sample rate of 1.25 gigasamples per second, or 500 megahertz if 4 distinct unique channels are used. It uses the JESD204B data converter interface, which simplifies the digital interface between the FPGA and the DAC. This DAC provides excellent noise and harmonic distortion performance, perfect for use as a signal generator. It also has the ability to generate onboard sine waves with the internal NCO mixer. This allows signal generation without the need of an external processor and can be used as a simple DDS for generating sine waves. The THS3217 is a high-performance differential to single-ended amplifier with options for gain and filtering. It incorporates many of the features that would normally be implemented with two stages. The input performs a differential to single-ended conversion. The final stage then provides some gain if needed to drive 50 ohm loads. This amplifier can be used with a single supply between 8 to 15 volts or a split supply from plus or minus 4 volts to plus or minus 7.5 volts. Flexible input options allow for a wide range of common modes to accommodate various DACs, and an interstage filter can be applied some filtering before the output gain stage. Typically, this circuit can be used to provide about 500 MHz of signal bandwidth with nominal swings of up to 11 volts peak-to-peak on 100 ohms. The THS3091 and THS3095 are single-channel, high-voltage buffers. These amplifiers are typically used to provide the final drive stage into 50-ohm loads on the output of waveform generators. The output of these stages can go as high as plus or minus 13 volts peak-to-peak at plus or minus 16 volts supply. If more drive strength is required, these amplifiers can be cascaded in parallel configurations to provide more drive current. Care must be taken in these cases to ensure proper implementation to reduce distortion. The LMH5401 is a very wide-band, fully differential amplifier with a gain bandwidth of 8 GHz. It has the ability to support from DC up to 1 GHz of signal bandwidth with very good harmonic performance and provides some gain as well. This device can be used to buffer the DAC output to drive a system that requires a high-performance, wide-band differential signal. The LMK04828 is one of a family of ultra-low jitter clock generators and clock buffers. This device is very useful in systems using the JESD204B digital interface. It has the ability to generate clocks and SysRef signals required for subclass 1 operation as defined in the JESD204B standard. This device family is used extensively on all of our current and next generation ADCs and DACs as a low noise clock source and SysRef source. The TSW14J56 is our high-performance JESD204B capture and pattern generator card. It has an FPGA which is used to capture data from an ADC, or in this case, as the pattern generator for our waveform generator front end. It is equipped with a fast USB 3 interface to transfer data quickly and a large DDR3 memory depth to handle up to 2 gigasamples of pattern data. HSDC Pro is the default software GUI for evaluation of ADC and DAC EVMs. It has the ability to connect and control all of our high-speed capture and pattern generator cards. This can be used to perform FFT analysis as well as generate and load patterns into the memory of the pattern generators to drive our DACs. The next few slides will cover the performance of the three active channels. First, let's answer the question of why an active channel is needed. High-speed DACs are very good at converting digital patterns into analog voltages at very high speeds. However, they are not very good at driving loads with high amounts of current. Typically, a DAC is terminated with an output transformer and is only capable of driving 1 volt peak-to-peak on a 50-ohm load. Active interfaces allow the DAC to be DC coupled, which is not possible with a transformer, and also provides a means to provide an output signal greater than 1 volt. In most cases, a signal generator may be needed to provide a 5 to 20 volt signal amplitude depending on the application. The three paths that are available on this design include a path with just the THS3217, which will provide the highest bandwidth up to 500 MHz with the signal amplitudes around 5 volts peak to peak. The second path is adding the THS39X amplifier to the output of the THS3217 to provide some more drive strength to accommodate up to 25 volts peak to peak with about 50 MHz of signal bandwidth. The third path is a fully differential wideband path from DC up to 1 GHz using the LMH5401. This is a TINA model of the interface circuits for the DAC to the THS3217. The DAC is modeled as a current source architecture with a 30 milliamp swing. This may be adjusted to match the DAC configuration. There is a wideband anti-imaging filter at the output of the DAC which will provide some attenuation of the DAC images in the second Nyquist zone. The THS3217 is configured to use the interstage filter, which in this case is defined around 300 to 400 MHz. The final output is designed to drive a 50-ohm load. In this specific implementation, the DAC is set for 20 milliamps of swing into 25 ohms. The THS3217 input stage converts this voltage swing into a single-ended signal internally. This is then passed to the interstage filter, which helps reduce any out-of-band harmonics and images in preparation for the final gain stage. Overall, the frequency response of this system is a combination of the 500 MHz low-pass filter at the DAC output and the 320 MHz interstage filter. The gain is expected to be 3.75 volts per volt. With a 50-ohm load, the max swing will be 1.875 volts peak-to-peak. The simulation results from TINA and the measured results as shown on a spectrum analyzer correlate the expected performance of the design. The frequency response shows a low pass function around 350 MHz. The high voltage output channel is comprised of the DAC 38J84 driving the THS3217, which converts the signal from differential to single-ended. The final output stage is made up of the THS39X, which is capable of driving up to 26 volts peak-to-peak into a 50-ohm load. The circuit is shown here with two THS391s working in parallel to provide more drive strength. The 50 MHz filter between the THS3217 and the THS3091 determine the overall frequency response of the channel. In this specific implementation, the same reasoning can be applied for the THS3217 as in the first channel. The gain is expected for the THS3217 to be around 3.75. The interstage filter between the THS3217 and the THS3091 has a voltage gain of 0.75. The gain of the final THS3091 stage is expected to be around 4. Overall, the gain is expected to be about 11.25. With a 50 ohm load and a 1 volt peak-to-peak signal into the input of the THS3217, the expected swing on the 50 ohm load is 5.625 volts peak-to-peak. The overall frequency response will be low pass of 45 MHz as determined by the response of the interstage filter. The simulation and the measured results are shown and correlates with the expected response of the design. The third channel output is comprised of the DAC 38J84 driving into the LMH5401. The LMH5401 is an amplifier capable of taking a fully differential input signal and driving a fully differential output signal. This type of output could be used to actively drive DC-coupled wideband signals into devices requiring differential signals. This design takes the differential output of the DAC and provides a buffered differential output signal with a gain of 3.5x. The frequency response is a function of the filter between the DAC and fully differential amplifier. In this case, it is a low-pass response with a frequency corner of around 500 MHz. Simulations of the TINA circuit and the measured results on the TSW3080 EVM correlate the performance of the design. The TSW3080 provides a reference design coupling our latest DAC 38J84 2.5 gigasample per second DAC with four different output options. A transformer-coupled interface provides an AC-coupled interface capable of driving 1 volt peak-to-peak from 1 MHz to 1 GHz. A wideband active interface implementation was shown using the THS3217, which allowed some gain and a DC-coupled signal bandwidth up to 500 MHz. This interface is capable of driving voltage swings up to 8 volts peak-to-peak. For systems that require larger voltage swings with an upper frequency limitation of 50 MHz, the THS3091 amplifier can be coupled with the THS3217. In this implementation, the output is capable of driving up to 26 volts peak-to-peak. Finally, a fully differential input-to-output DC to 1 GHz active interface with gain was shown using the LMH5401 amplifier. For more details, look at the TI design TIDA00684. Thank you.